The next, we're going to talk about the investment demand curve. So for the investment demand curve, on the vertical axis, you are going to see the real interest rate. On the horizontal axis, you're going to see the quantity of investment, saying thousands of dollars. So you are going to see the real interest rate as a price tag of investment. How so? Typically, if you're a firm owner, you are an entrepreneur, you want to invest in factory, equipment, or warehouses. You don't have the money to invest just like that. You will have to borrow from the bank. So if you borrow from the bank, that means you will have to return the principal plus real interest. So if the real interest becomes higher, that will hinder you from investing in factory equipment because you find it unaffordable to borrow from the bank. And therefore, just think about our law of demand. Here is similar. When the price of a loan, meaning the real interest rate, goes up, that means your quantity demanded for investment or for borrowing from the bank to invest will go down. And therefore, there is a negative relationship between the real interest rate and the quantity demanded for investment. And therefore, we're going to see a negatively sloped investment demand curve, where the higher the real interest rate, the lower the quantity of investment.